in that weird place of, I don't know what I'm doing, and it's kind of weird. You know, again, like, as long as you're not hurting anybody else and you love it, why not? Just do it. You know, just do it. Kind of thing. Fun, fun. It's all about fun. If it's not fun, don't do it. I can do it.
What are you trying to do now?
Pick the helmet nose.
Can you get to it?
No. It's alright.
So what was your day like?
My day?
Yeah.
Like any other day. It's like this. Kind of running around. I'm just gonna break this chat. Make sure you get all the fruit flies there. I'm very happy it's Friday. Just like to switch my hat and do this instead. So marketing with this one, but we do it every month, so people generally like know what we're all about, what we're doing.
Yeah, I'd have to say I've definitely seen Teresa develop as an artist. Like, even though it's been like less than a year, like, her figures have gotten superb. I'm not quite sure what it is, but I know she's produces just like a lot of work.
Well, Teresa's artwork has been even like a huge inspiration on me, and I love like being in the studio with her and painting with her, because like she's giving me ideas for techniques and stuff that I never would have used. When you're an artist, the more you work, the more your stuff is, you know, it's gonna evolve, it's gonna get better, it's gonna change.
It was definitely like, you know, as a kid, just, I just remember always wanting to like create things, like imaginary friends, or I had this thing in my head, like any character I would draw, it would come to life. So anything I would draw, I would like draw it with the intention of like either a companion or a friend or an adventurer. And then it just kind of evolved out of that, just passing time. And you know, I always kind of was quiet. My mom didn't think I was gonna talk. She thought I was gonna be a mute, you know, so I was just very introverted. And it just like, you know, just being a kid, you know, so that got me into it. And then, you know, it just evolved from there. My background, where I got educated with my art academically, I didn't start painting or drawing or doing anything art-wise until I got out of high school. I didn't really know what I was going to do when I got out of high school, but I knew one thing I absolutely loved was drawing. So I figured if I'm going to invest in something, it might as well be something I enjoy, right? So I went to Manchester Community College and I got my associate's degree in visual fine arts, and I met a lot of really interesting, amazing people in the art department out there. The professors and students that were taking classes out there were very influential to like what I do today, even. The mentality that I have behind the paintings or things that I try to create, I find are the majority of them tend to be narrative, whether it be sequential or, you know, a portrait of somebody that's expressionistic and it just seems like, you know, little accessories or accents like tell a story. For instance, the jarred painting that I did over a year ago was sequential and was much more like academic and just kind of like again, research and experimentation for me to kind of ramp up what I used to do, you know, because I hadn't painted in a long time. I started painting jars, and that's what kicked me back into gear. So, yeah, and it was kind of like you could see, like, a calendar, like, okay, like, you know, that was going on that day, and then, like, you know, I went more into an abstract realm, and then I went back to photorealism, and so it kind of, like, quoted a bunch of stuff, and then, you know, they all kind of melded together, whereas I have a couple portrait paintings, you know, hanging that, you know, are very quiet moments that I find are very quiet, subtle, and I try to express, like, some sort of confidence or, you know, just, like, some sort of energy throughout them. I do. I like motorcycles. Yeah! I think motorcycles and cars, but for me it's more motorcycles, are like a perfect hybrid of something that's aesthetic and functional. And I just there's so many like guts to them, and it's very spiritual. Yeah, see, that's their call. I remember one day my dad has ridden like since he was 20, so he had a motorcycle and I would always ride with him. And one day he must have had an awesome day at work or something. He was in a special mood and he threw me the keys. He's like, "You want to learn how to ride?" And of course I was like, "Yes, yes I do." It was just, it's freedom. It's like flying, you know, and you know, it's almost like a dance too. You're going through turns and it's very physical and fluid. It's very fluid for me, so I love them. What fascinates me about the pose of my subjects is, you know, I think obviously life in motion, always been a huge fan of, again, mentioning sequential art and animation, you know, comics and like, you know, cartoons, and seeing something that is like a traditional medium like drawing come to life. So I mean, I can, I'll like draw very like stoic or static things, but for me personally, my own selfish, you know, venture is I love, you know, to show human figure in movement because it's constantly moving. Like even you're sitting still, your pulse is still racing. You know? So the things that have influenced me the most in terms of being a creative person or just being a person in general have most definitely been family and friends and interaction. So I was really fortunate growing up. My father, my mother constantly took me to like, you know, science museums, and like my dad is an inventor by nature, you know. So I just remember always going into the garage and he'd be working like all hours of the night, and I would see like these like machines or mechanisms he was building. And I obviously being, you know, young, I was like, I don't know what a fuel cell is, like, you know, but just seeing like these lights and these things that he would create, and he was very quiet about it. He never really talked much about it, but I just, you know, always admired that. So like, you know, machines and inventions and just obviously creating something out of nothing, you know, was constantly going on in my childhood. Springs, seeing like, you know, murals and art shows that were popping up around here, and I got really excited. Like it really, you know, rejuvenated what, like, you know, I that love I had like years back. Like, why did I do this kind of thing? So I started painting again, and I got involved with a couple people, locals from Stafford, that really encouraged me, like, you know, get into these druid shows, like, you know, you should really push yourself. So I did, and next thing I know, I placed second in Munson Annual's art show, and I was like literally like brought to tears. Like I couldn't really believe that, you know, this is something that people like, you know. It was like a weird feeling for me. So I just was still on that wave of adrenaline of like, okay, like what else can I do, you know? So I kept painting, kept creating things, and just posting them on Facebook just like all the time. And you know, to the point of, I'm sure it annoys a couple people, but I was like just throwing everything at the wall. I'm like, I want to see what sticks here, you know. And people started like, you know, speaking up and being like, I really like what you're doing, like do more, and like, what about this, you should try this. So it just kind of snowballed. I started meeting more artists, more creative people that felt the same way I did. And then we got the space here, Studio 4, on Main Street in Stafford. And we've just been doing shows on Arts on Main for over a year now. And it's just been amazing. Like, we just like find ourselves like constantly like doing these really incredible events and meeting other incredible people. And it's rejuvenating. It's like the arts do exist. Like, the community does need it. And we're a part of it. Freedom, freedom, freedom. The day I decided, when like I felt absolutely comfortable saying I'm an artist, I don't know the exact day, but I know the situation before that has always been like, oh, so you're an artist. Like, you know, you're covered in paint all the time and you look like you're constantly scatterbrained. I always felt embarrassed. I always felt like it was like, you know, there's some sort of, you know, I don't know. I just felt like it was taboo for some reason, because it was just like my own personal struggle. Like, not that I didn't enjoy what I did. It was just like, in my own brain, it didn't feel like the right thing. I wasn't doing the right thing. Like, I didn't have the 2.5 kids. I didn't have the white picket fence, you know? And, you know, you can't always define yourself by what's going on around you all the time. And I think that's unfortunately what I had been doing for years and years and years. And so the day when I realized, like, you know, when all of this stuff was going on, I was like, you know what? I am an artist. Like, just let it in. It's fine. And I have never felt more myself. In 20 years, painting. I know that's like a very like simplistic answer, but painting. I will be heartbroken if like I was able to see a prediction of my future in 20 years and I wasn't painting. That would break my heart. So I think that's good hope. I don't think I'm ever gonna stop. I hope I don't. And if I do and I watch this video, this is a warning to myself. Pick up a brush. but yeah, I hope I'm painting. I hope I'm still, at least if I'm not doing that, something creative, networking, being involved in a creative community, you know, places like Stafford or other towns that are looking to really rejuvenate themselves culturally and creatively. They need it, you know. And you know, I think, you know, there's like a lot of dark places and like negative things that go on every day. And, you know, it's our part to, like, you know, make it interesting. Like, you know, we can change things. We can, you know, if you don't like what you're doing, you can change it. You know, with support and your own will, you can.